Programmers today turn to the web for a variety of reasons. They use the web for just-in-time learning of new languages and APIs. They look for clarification of familiar classes or functions. Finally, they also use the web as a reminder of well-known lines of code they prefer to copy rather than type manually. Although general-purpose search engines and browsers enable programmers to find relevant information, they are not designed to support the programming task directly. To get accurate results, users have to typically specify the programming language and framework version they're using, and they may have to look through several pages to find appropriate code examples. We propose extending the existing autocomplete programming interface to include web search. By integrating web search directly in the development environment, user queries can be augmented with relevant programming context, and the search results display can be customized to display available code examples. To demonstrate these ideas, we implemented Blueprint, a plugin for the Adobe Flex Builder development environment, and studied its use in a comparative laboratory study and a 3-month field deployment. Let's follow Jenny as she uses Blueprint to prototype a web application for comparing power consumption. First, Jenny needs to retrieve power usage data from a web service that returns XML formatted data. Although Jenny has written similar code previously, she can't remember the exact code she needs. She does remember that one of the main classes involved began with URL. So she types URL into her code and uses autocomplete to remember the URL loader class. Although she remembers the class name, Jenny still doesn't know how to use it. With another hotkey, Jenny brings up the Blueprint search interface, which automatically starts searching for URL loader. Blueprint augments Jenny's query with the language and framework version she's using, and returns appropriate examples that show how to use a URL loader. Jenny scrolls through the first few examples and sees one that creates an XML object from the response data. She selects the parts she wants and presses Enter. The code, along with the query she used and the source URL, are pasted in her project. Jenny makes some edits to the examples and runs the code in Flex Builder's debugger to confirm the XML has loaded and to inspect its format. Next, she wants to change the user's mouse cursor to a busy cursor while the data is being loaded, but since she has never done this before, she just types busy cursor in the Blueprint search box. She looks over the code in the first example returned and sees the line, cursor manager set busy cursor. She selects this line and presses Enter to paste it into her project. Then she selects the code for removing the busy cursor and presses Enter again. But now when she tries to compile, Jenny gets an error. She forgot to import cursor manager. She goes back to the busy cursor query and adds the relevant line to her code. Finally, Jenny wants to make a chart for the data. She searches for charting and docks the Blueprint result window as a panel in her development environment, so she can browse the results in a large persistent view. When source pages provide a running example, Blueprint presents this example next to the source code. Eventually, Jenny decides on a line chart and copies the example code from the Blueprint panel into her project. She modifies it to bind the chart to her XML data. After only a few minutes, her prototype is complete. We deployed Blueprint in the field through the Adobe Labs website and studied tool adoption over 3 months. Over 2,000 people installed and used Blueprint, and over 150 of these people used Blueprint more than 10 times. Many integrated Blueprint in their workflow and began relying on it to accomplish their programming tasks.